Diplomatic appointments rarely make headlines, yet Joe Biden's pick for the new U.S. ambassador to India is all over the news in California, not for his appointment to India, but for his actions at home. We're talking about Eric Garcetti, the mayor of America's second largest city in the land of Hollywood, Los Angeles. Mr. Garcetti has been selected by the American president to serve as the country's new ambassador to India. If his appointment is confirmed by the U.S. Senate, which is a mere formality, Garcetti will be moving into the sprawling Roosevelt House in New Delhi and taking command of the American embassy here. And as we look forward to hosting Mr. Garcetti in India, it's worth tracking some recent developments involving him. Last Thursday, some 50 protesters descended on Garcetti's mayoral residence in L.A. They vandalized his home, leaving behind trash and graffiti that read, "Your sweeps are violent, we will not be silent," and "Housing is a right." This is what the people said. What was this about? A new ordinance which the mayor had passed the same evening. It's an anti-camping ordinance which prohibits sitting, sleeping or storing items on public properties anywhere in LA. Basically, using public property for personal means. The LA City Council approved this ordinance with a 13-2 vote last Wednesday. The mayor signed it into law the next day, and this angered some people who say the law will turn homeless people into criminals. You see, Los Angeles has long struggled with a homeless crisis. Let me show you some images. Images of illegal encampments present all over the city. The pandemic proliferated this crisis. Many more camps came up. The mayor wants to restrict such encampments. The people say the move is discriminatory because they have nowhere else to go. Listen to one such voice.
When COVID first started, they almost, like, in a sense, allowed us to be out here and didn't really push anything, you know? As time went by, then it became an issue. And then now they started putting all these rules and telling us that we can't be here or there.
Now, in the mayor's defense, he has set up a shelter program for those without a home, but it's not enough to stem the tide of homelessness, driven by high rents, family disputes, and the virus. For every person finding a spot in a shelter, someone else is becoming homeless. Critics say this largely is Garcetti's fault. They pointed the numbers. When Garcetti was elected the mayor in 2013, homeless people stood at 23,000. By 2020, that number had grown to 40,000. In 2021, they have grown to more than 66,400. That's almost a 50% jump. It's a serious crisis. And the mayor's new law could make it worse. And I'm not the one saying it. The people of Los Angeles are. And they also have some serious questions to ask of the mayor.
If you kick us out of here, you know, it's not like we're not outside anymore. We still live outside. We're homeless. So if you get us out of the park, we're just going to have to find someplace new to sleep outside. But the issue is they made all of outside illegal. So wherever we go, we're going to be harassed and told to leave. I understand society correctly. Tax dollars go to the government, then the government uses that tax dollars to help out the citizens. Clearly, that's not happening. So what's going on with the money?
What's going on with the money, he says. We don't have an answer to that. What we can tell you is that this is not the only controversy surrounding Eric Garcetti. Let me show you a headline. It's from November 2020, when BLM organizers staged a protest in LA. That's Black Lives Matter, BLM. They were asking Joe Biden to not pick Eric Garcetti for any cabinet position in his administration. Why was that? Because they said Garcetti had failed in handling the Los Angeles Police Department, the LAPD, which has often been accused of using violent and abusive tactics against communities of color. And there's more. A month prior, in October 2020, one of Eric Garcetti's key advisors was accused of sexual misconduct, of improper behavior, which some ex-employees at the mayor's office say Garcetti was aware of. In a lawsuit, they said that Garcetti knew about his advisor's behavior but did not do anything to stop it. The mayor has categorically denied this allegation, saying he knew nothing. But the American media still does not agree. On the 9th of July, Forbes carried this headline saying, "Biden chooses scandal-plagued LA Mayor Garcetti as India ambassador." Some reports even claim that the selection is not based on merit, but on Garcetti's closeness to Joe Biden. They say that he is a longtime Biden loyalist, having served as a co-chair of the Biden-Harris 2020 presidential campaign and a co-chair of the Vice Presidential Selection Committee. He has now been chosen as the next U.S. ambassador to India. So he is wishing Mr. Garcetti a smooth transition to New Delhi, along with the hope that the Biden administration will clarify on the many controversies surrounding this appointment. Vyond is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.